गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर माइक्रोब्स एंड ह्यूमन वेलफेयर. इन दैट वी हैव डन सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट, इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ माइक्रोब्स इन फूड प्रोडक्शन, एंड लिटिल बिट वी हैव डन रोल ऑफ माइक्रोब्स इन इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्शन. सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद दैट ओनली. नाउ टूडे इन इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट industrial purpose and also in medicinal part, there is very important role of different microbes. So let us start with antibiotics. Okay, so what are antibiotics? See, already we know that for bacterial diseases, different bacterial diseases, antibiotics are given which obstruct the pathway of bacteria and thus protect us from that particular disease. Okay, so antibiotic, anti means against, biotic means life, so it is related with the control, or we can say it prevents the development or growth of microbes which causes diseases. So in short, we can say that antibiotics are the molecules, or we can say it, these are against disease causing microbes. Okay, disease causing microbes. Now antibiotics was first invented by Alexander Fleming, and first antibiotic prepared was penicillin. First antibiotic was penicillin, and it was obtained from penicillium notatum. Okay, so penicillin was the first antibiotic. It was discovered by, or prepared by, we can say, not discovered, it was prepared by Alexander Fleming, and it was obtained from the bacteria Penicillium notatum. Now there are different antibiotics which acts on different microbes. In general, we can say these are the artificial microbes, okay, which are injected in our body so that our body will get protected against that particular disease. If that particular microbe will enter in our body, then at that time these microbes, they will protect our body. So similarly, see, you must have heard the term vaccination also. They were prepared separately. There's very little difference between vaccination and antibiotics. See, when already we are curing from some diseases, at that time antibiotics are given along with the medicine. Okay, if you are talking about cold and cough, or if you are talking about diphtheria and all these. So along with the medicine, antibiotics are also given, and whole we can say the treatment should be complete. It is never left in between. It should be complete, so that what will the antibiotic will do? It will obstruct the growth of that particular microbe in our body and protect our body from the disease. There are many effect uses.
and it is antibiotics are used in, just now I've told you, like diphtheria, then whooping cough. Okay. Whooping cough, even in leprosy also, even in leprosy also antibiotics are used. Okay, so antibiotics acts against the microbes which causes.
Antibiotics have improved our capacity to treat deadly diseases which must have killed millions all over the globe. There are many types of antibiotics. Like penicillin, I've told you, it is non-toxic to human, except for a small percentage which may develop to allergies. Then streptomycin. Streptomycin is effective against the acid-fast and gram-negative bacteria. Then tetracycline. It is used against number of streptomycetes and it is regarded as broad spectrum antibiotics and effective for the treatment caused by the gram negative and some of the gram positive bacteria. Now there are many different antibiotics also, like chloromycetine for dysentery, erythromycin for wound infection, diphtheria, polymyxin which helps in improvement of or treatment of air passage, then bacitracin, it is used for the treatment of surgical infection. So different antibiotics are there which improves the capacity to fight against all the diseases. Now, let us study upon some of the vitamins or see microbial fermentation, which is used for commercial production of several essential vitamins. Like riboflavin is synthesized by A. gossypii and E. gossypii. So vitamin B12 is also synthesized by microorganism.
Now, antibiotics, let us discuss some of the organic acid. Similarly, I told you that many microbes like bacteria, fungi, they help in the preparation of antibiotics. In the same way, there are many microbes which helps in the production of organic acid. So organic acid are produced with the help of microbes. In general, we can take many examples. Some of the examples I am telling you here, like acetic acid. Okay, so acetic acid is produced by the bacteria Acetobacter acetate. Okay, it is the bacteria which helps in the production of acetic acid. Now, citric acid, it is present in lemon. Okay, so citric acid is produced by aspergillus. Okay, it is produced by Aspergillus niger, which is a fungi. So that fungi helps in the production of citric acid. Now then we can take example of butyric acid. Okay, it is also produced by the bacteria named as Clostridium butyrate. Okay, so this bacteria helps in the production of butyric acid. And most common, everyone knows this, lactic acid. Okay, so this lactic acid, and we all know it is produced by lactobacillus. Yes, lactobacillus. Okay, it is also a name of bacteria only. So these are some of the organic acids which are produced with the help of microbes. Now, there are many other also, but just now we are discussing this much only for the organic acid. Now, there are many enzymes, okay, which can be obtained by several microbes on a commercial scale. Like we can take the example of proteases, amylases, then glucose isomerase, glucose oxidases. All these enzymes are produced with the help of microbes. See, all these enzymes also have large uses also. They have large application in different fields. Like microbial proteases, it is used in laundry. And amylases is used in textile and paper industries, bread production, chocolate and corn syrup, okay. And then fungal pectinases and proteases, these are used in clarification of fruit juices. Then glucose oxidase, it is used to remove oxygen from the soft drink. Lipases, used in detergent formulation, and also it is helpful in removing stains from the laundry. Okay, so all these enzymes, different enzymes, are used in different for different purposes, and they are produced with the help of different microbes. Even you can see that bacteria, streptococcus. Okay, streptococcus bacteria is used in the production of streptokinase. And after that, it is genetically engineered and is used as a clot buster. So obviously, clot buster means it removes clot from the blood vessels of patient. Okay, due to microbial infraction, which may lead to heart attack. So indirectly, all these enzymes which are produced with the help of microbes are helpful for the human. Ethanol, it is produced from yeast. It is used for the commercial production of ethanol. Yeast is used for the production of ethanol. Then now, these all are the different enzymes, and whatever we have done, enzyme production, antibiotics, then organic acid, production of organic acid, amino acid, all these will come under the industrial production. So by this we can be able to identify different microbes which are useful for in industrial production.
Just now I told you that microbes helps in the production of biogas also. So biogas, main component of biogas is methane. Okay, it contains approximately 60% of methane and 40% of carbon dioxide. So now, how does biogas is produced? See, the bacteria known as methanobacterium, okay, it is produced by bacteria named as methanobacterium. Okay, now this methanobacterium, it acts on, okay, it acts on celluloid
component. We all know that plants, cells, leaves, these all are made up of cellulose. So it acts on a cellulosic compound and helps in the production of biogas. Now here, mostly in lower classes, we have learned biogas is prepared with the help of dung, cow dung. Why? The most important reason is that this cow dung, it has both cellulosic, it has both cellulosic as well as methanogens, okay. So it is very helpful. So and biogas can be easily prepared with it because both are present here. So the cow dung is mostly used for the production of biogas. Clear? So we can not say only cow dung, all the cattle's. Okay? So cattle dung is containing both cellulosic and methanogens. That's why it is used for the production of biogas. And we all know what is the importance of biogas. It helps in the production of electricity also. It is used in as a fuel in kitchens also. Okay? And the remaining biogas is prepared in a biogas plant, and the leftover thing also, it is used as a manure in fields. Okay, so here microbes is helping in the production of. Now the steps involved in biogas production. See, biogas plant, it consists of concrete tank in which bio waste is collected and slurry of dung is fed. After that, the floating tank, it is covered, okay, and placed over the slurry, which keeps on rising as a gas is produced in the tank. Now, these gas are produced by the action of microbes. Okay, microbes synthesize hydrocarbons and oxygenated compounds, which may serve as a liquid fuel also. I've told you just now. And microbes helps in the action of, or we can say, petroleum formation, exploration of petroleum. They are used in enhancing the recovery of petroleum. After that, next step is the slurry, which keeps on rising due to the production of gas. It is connected to the pipe, okay, through the outlet, and from that pipe, biogas is supplied to the nearby houses. And the spent slurry, it is removed through the other outlet and it is used as a fertilizer. Just now I've told you that the residual which is left over after the formation of gas, it is used as a manure fertilizer in fields. And biogas plants are obviously, they are built in a rural area where cattle dung is available. And why we are using cattle dung for biogas production? You know that, just now I've told you. And here, hydrogen is also a fuel which is obtained here, which is a very valuable fuel. Okay, and it has the capability of producing hydrogen gas from water in sunlight. Algae have the capability of producing hydrogen gas from sunlight. And this process is biophotolysis. And it is enhanced by the enzyme hydrogenase. So,
whole what is done? The bacteria, Methanobacterium, is added in that anaerobic sludge during the sewage treatment, and these bacteria are also present in the rumen of the cattle, excreta, and it is these excreta is rich in bacteria. So these dungs are used for the generation of biogas, and which is used in cooking and for supplying electricity. Now, some of the microbes are also used as a biocontrol agent. Now, biocontrol, it means use of biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests. Okay, so there are many microbes, which is used for the management of microbial pathogens, insect pest, nematodal pest, as well as weeds of agriculture. Okay, so these are exploited as biocides. Like insects as biocontrol agent, like we can say ladybird, example, dragonflies, these are helpful in getting rid of aphids and mosquito. Then we can take viruses as a biocontrol agent. See, some of the viruses are helps in controlling the several insects like moth, budworms, earworms, and some bacteria are also there, which is used as a bacterial biocides against the microorganism, like Bacillus thuringiensis. It is very helpful against insects, pests of plants, as well as against the mosquito larva. Obviously, so indirectly it is controlling malaria. And fungi also, it also acts as a biocontrol. See, some of the fungi like Ascaronia aeleoides, okay, it is used to control a range of insect pests. And there are many species which are free living fungi and are very common in root ecosystem. It is very effective against several plant diseases. There are some viruses, bacteria, fungi, which helps in the developing suitable bioherbicides, and they are found to be most ideal organism used for different weeds plants, okay, and especially desirable, they are beneficial insects which is conserved to aid in overall integrated pest management program also. Okay, so obviously it will help in ecological process, and we can say they are ecological sensitive. They are developed in a ecological sensitive area. It can be treated there.
After the topic biogas, role of microbes in biogas production, or we can simply say that role of microbes in generation of energy, we are going to discuss about biofertilizers. Okay, biofertilizer, it is a very common name term. We all are familiar with this term. So different microbes are there which are helpful in preparation of biofertilizers, and or indirectly we can say they are improving the fertility of the soil, thus helps in the, or we can say acts as a fertilizer. Okay, now like if we are taking in bacteria also, fungi
also help acts as a biofertilizers. Then cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria means blue green algae. Yes, blue green algae, that is a cyanobacteria. Now all these, they help in increasing the fertility of the soil, or it maintains the nutrient content of the soil. How? Like if we are talking about bacteria, we all are familiar with rhizobium. Okay, so some of the bacteria, they develops the habit, or they have the capacity to enrich the nutrient in the soil, like rhizobium, azotobacter, spirillum. All these, they provide nutrients to the soil, or we can say it enriches the soil. It improves the fertility of the soil. Now similarly, fungi, what does the fungi do? It behaves as a symbiotic. It develops a symbiotic relation. Okay, it develops a symbiotic relation with the roots of some of the plants, and thus it helps in improving the fertility of the soil, or we can say it helps in improving the quality of the soil. Like example, you can say mycorrhiza. Okay, mycorrhiza is the example, and it helps in absorption of, it helps in absorption of phosphorus, and also it maintains fertility. Clear? Now cyanobacteria, again I told you blue green algae, you can take the example of Anabina nostoc. Anabina nostoc, it is a very good biofertilizer. So all these are helpful in the maintenance of soil nutrients, and it enriches the soil.
So I've told you already what are the microbes which are helpful as a biofertilizers. So it enriches the nutrient quality of the soil, and most common biofertilizers, I've given you example like rhizobium, Anabina, association of nitrogen fixing bacteria, cyanobacteria, all these. Okay, and biofertilizers, it mainly contains living microorganism, which when applied to seeds, plant surface or soil, it even on the interior of the plants, it promotes growth by increasing the supply and availability of primary nutrients to the host plant. So they are biologically active products. Okay, they are biologically active product which helps in biological nitrogen fixation in various crops, and helps in maintaining the nutrient content of the soil. We have studied different microbes, its role in different fields, industrial purpose, household purpose, in generating energy, in biofertilizers. So all these are the microbes. Obviously, in starting only I've told you there are microbes which are helpful as well as which are harmful for the human beings. So we have discussed some of the microbes which are helpful for human beings. Okay, now watch the video properly and note down the points from it and have a nice day. Take care.